A blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter. Let me read to you the circular letter number 2022-013 from the Office of the Bishop, Diocese of Bacolod. Greetings. The Diocese of Bacolod is one in prayer with the whole nation as we embark in this political exercise of choosing our national and local leaders come May 9, 2022. In response to the CBCP call for 3 days of intense prayer from May 8 to May 10 for the 2022 elections, I am hereby encouraging our parishes and chaplaincies with our lay organizations and BECs to organize prayer brigades for the elections. I am also calling on our women and men religious orders, especially our contemplative communities, to do the same in their convents and houses of formation. Let us also lend support to our PPCRV volunteers and social community correspondents who will be keeping watch these elections. Please tune in to our radio, DYAF 1143 kilowatts, for updates. To create awareness among our people as to the importance of these elections, particularly in the exercise of the right to suffrage, please include during your celebration of Masses from May 8 to May 10 the prayer for the 2022 national elections. On Monday, May 9, in prayerful solidarity, upon the opening of the polling precincts at 6 o'clock in the morning, let us have our church bells rung for 10 minutes as a reminder to all of the sacredness of our ballots and the need for all of us to make a moral choice when we vote. May the Lord of History guide us as His people these elections. With my prayers and pastoral blessing, Patricio A. Buson, SDBDD, Bishop of Bacolod. By order of His Excellency, Reverend Father Roy Christian Isulcon, Chancellor Secretary. For tomorrow, May 9, 2022, Election Day, instead of the 6:30 Mass, our Mass here in Carmelite Monastery will be at 5:30 in the morning. Dear brothers and sisters, the fourth Sunday of Easter is called the Good Shepherd Sunday. In the Gospel, Jesus says that He protects the sheep the Father has given Him. He also gives the sheep, His disciples, eternal life. We also celebrate today the World Day of Prayer for Vocations. We pray to the Father to send shepherds of souls who can lead us back to Him and who, like Him, can selflessly offer themselves for the good of the flock. We also pray for the gift of faith, hope, and love for our hard-working, loving, and caring mothers in celebration of the Mother's Day. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of His minister, Reverend Father Roy Christian Isulcon.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea, raise your voice. Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. We say, I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
You are Lord, the Holy One. You
Almighty and ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Rejected by the Jews, the message of the risen Lord is brought by Paul and Barnabas to the Gentiles, who accept it willingly. God fills with joy those who accept his message. The first reading.
The first reading. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas continued from Perga and reached Antioch in Pisidia. On the Sabbath, they entered the synagogue and took their seats. Many Jews and worshippers who were converts to Judaism followed Paul and Barnabas, who spoke to them and urged them to remain faithful to the grace of God. On the following Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. When the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy and with violent abuse contradicted what Paul said. Both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly and said, "It was necessary that the word of God be spoken to you first. But since you reject it and condemn yourselves as unworthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles. For so the Lord has commanded us, 'I have made you a light to the Gentiles, that you may be an instrument of salvation to the ends of the earth.'" The Gentiles were delighted when they heard this and glorified the word of the Lord. All who were destined for eternal life came to believe, and the word of the Lord continued to spread through the whole region. The Jews, however, incited the women of prominence who were worshippers and the leading men of the city, stirred up a persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and expelled them from their territory. So they took the dust from their feet in protest against them and went to Iconium. The disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sheep of his flock.
Jesus, the Good Shepherd, will manifest himself at the end as the glorious Lamb, who will reward his faithful people, those who have listened to his voice. The second reading,
a reading from the book of Revelations. I, John, had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches on their hands. Then one of the elders said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they stand before God's throne and worship him in the day and the night in his temple. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them. They will not hunger or thirst anymore, nor will the sun or any heat strike them. For the Lamb who is in the center of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to springs of life-giving water. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. And no one can take them out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter, and it is known as the Good Shepherd Sunday. We thank the Lord for this grace that before we go to the precincts and cast our votes, our Sunday before the May 9 elections is about shepherding, about leadership. The eminent scripture scholar Raymond Brown notes that the image of the Good Shepherd in scriptures is long been used even during the time of the Old Testament. The Good Shepherd imagery is applied to the leaders of Israel. They are applied to priests, they are applied to the kings, and they are even applied to prophets. The Good Shepherd image, it is about leadership. And in the New Testament, it is applied to Jesus, who himself has taken the title the Good Shepherd, because he himself notes in the Gospels, "I am the Good Shepherd." And his description of the Good Shepherd is very well articulated. He says, "I am the Good Shepherd because I am willing to lay down my life for the sheep." Beautiful imagery. One who is to lead should be willing to lay down his life for the sheep. The context of Christian leadership, my dear friends, is as such. It is a leadership of example. That's why I love our second reading for today, because it points to the very purpose of leadership. Who is a leader? Who is worthy to shepherd the flock? I'd like to go back to the very words in that vision of John. Then one of the elders said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they stand before God's throne and worship Him day and night in His temple. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them. They will not hunger or thirst anymore, nor will the sun or any heat strike them. For the Lamb who is in the center of the throne will shepherd them." Beautiful. Who is then worthy to be the shepherd? The one who has given his life for the sheep. Because from the blood of the Lamb, these people, the multitude, are to wash their robes clean. Sinong sundon mga leader? Ang gulpi lang nagtuhaw? Sinong sundon mga leader? Ang wala sang may ipakita nga ebidensya sang iya pagserbisyo? Sinong sundon mga leader? Ang may kinhimo para sa akon. Beautiful. The Lamb is to be worshipped. The Lamb sits on the throne. The Lamb is to shepherd God's people, because by His blood, He showed His concern and love for them. And what do you call that? That is integrity. That is good example. Tika namin. When I was a young seminarian, I studied Sacred Heart Seminary, now Bishop of San Carlos, Bishop Jerry Albinasa, used to tell seminarians, if we are to follow a leader, who will that leader be? And he would point to the cross and say, if I am to follow a leader, I will follow him. Because before he exacts things to be done by people, he did it first. Beautiful. He's willing to sacrifice. And as a matter of fact, he has already sacrificed himself for the people. Beautiful. That's why in the Old Testament, so many times, so many instances, God will castigate unfaithful leaders of His people. Ginaakigan niya. Ining mga lidere sang Israel nga wala nagatuman sang ila pagka-leader. Because instead of feeding the flock, instead of providing them, leading them to fresh waters, they preyed on them. Beautiful. That's why God is angry in the Old Testament. Each time, leaders are not faithful. Faithful to what? Faithful to their calling. Panami, no? The context of the Good Shepherd Sunday is also in the context of praying for vocations. Because actually, the vocation to the priesthood is a vocation to service. And that is the image of Christian leadership. It is for service. It is for the giving of the self. And as leaders, we are not simply accountable to people or the flock. I'd like to read that part of the Gospel of John. "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me. Beautiful. And this is what at times leaders forget, as if they own the flock, as if they own the people. But in the end, leadership is not simply being accountable to people, but first and foremost, being accountable to God. Because the people were simply given to the leader by God. They are not ours. They are of God. Beautiful. Yes, leaders are to be held accountable to the people. But leaders are first and foremost be accountable to God. Tikanami. Ang tatay is first and foremost accountable to God. Paano niyang leadership sa family, di ba? Din siya accountable. Yes, accountable siya sa iyong kabataan, accountable siya sa iyong esposa, pero he is first and foremost accountable to God. And that is true to any position of leadership, because these people are simply given to me by God. That is very clear in the case of Jesus. When he does things, when he is with people, he would always go back to that basic thing. These people are not mine, but they are first and foremost of God. And perhaps that is a beautiful criterion by which we are to make our leaders accountable, by which we are to select our leaders. Do they serve in the name of God? Diba? Masimali patanta? Or do they simply serve in their name? And Jesus is a very good description of the contrast between the good shepherd and those who prey on the flock. Anong iya na description? Ang mga sinuhulan na, the hired ones. Tika namin, nag-contrast. The good shepherd and the hired ones. Because as far as the hired ones are concerned, their loyalty is simply to themselves and their interest. But look at the good shepherd. The loyalty of the good shepherd is not with wealth or any interest. His loyalty is with God. Because he knows that these people are simply given to him by God. Tiyan mo na, we simply follow patronage politics. What is that kind of politics? A politics of loyalties. Tagaan ka sa umuni, paborde, paborto. Para loyal siya sa imo. Fans club. Pero si Kristo bala nangita sa fans club? Wala. Ang mga disipulo bala ni Kristo nangita fans club? Wala. Their service is not that of loyalties. They're simply loyal to the one who sent them and the one who gave them the sheep, the flock. As a matter of fact, in our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, kanamis ang description, ariay, both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly and said, with such boldness, how can they say things with boldness? How can they proclaim the gospel with boldness? They can do it because their only loyalty is with God and the one who sent them to feed the flock. And what did they experience out of that boldness? Arikanami. Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly and said, it was necessary that the word of God be spoken to you first, but since you reject it, and condemn yourselves as unworthy of eternal life, now we turn to the Gentiles. Beautiful. In their boldness, because their loyalty is simply to the one who sent them and has given them the flock, they are to face rejection. Diba? Rejection. And as they were rejected, they went to the Gentiles to preach. Beautiful. No? Kung fans club lang dito, popularity contest, eh, di ba? Oh. At times when we talk about morality, some people would associate it with numbers. O, kung ilaubra na nasang tananti, o, okay na. O, padamo-damo ta. O. But that's not the point. Padamo-damo, mga trolls. O, kinanglan, i-condition ta, nga damo, gid. Damo-damo, trolls. O. But since the loyalty of Paul and Barnabas is with the one who sent them, with the gospel, then they can speak with boldness. Beautiful. And they have to face rejection. Di mga simbahan. Ang simbahan niya wala nag-ili-ili sa mga tao. Ang simbahan niya wala yan nag-conform lang yan sa gusto niyo. Ang simbahan niya may humble kid permi. Maskin hindi yung pagusto. Because our loyalty is to the one who sent us. Our loyalty is to take care of the flock. That is leadership. So my dear friends, hopefully, when we look at our leaders, we ask the question, is this a leader who is willing to die for me? Is this a leader who is willing to bleed for me? Is this person talking to me now in front of me has done something concrete to demonstrate his love? Like the lamb who has bled for people, and from that blood of loving, of service, they are to wash clean their robes. A beautiful imagery. So as we go to the polling places this Monday, let it be our criterion. The leadership by example, a leadership of integrity, a leadership that is shown in a concrete act of loving. And as such, we are to follow the Lamb because he has proven his love for us. Hindi na magpabulag-bulag, hindi na magpainto-into. Lantawon sa maayo, kagpit magpili sang in sakto. May the Lord bless his people, the Philippines. May the Lord guide us in our choices. May we choose that leader who will truly die for us and be a good example, not simply for us, but for the next generation of Filipinos. Amen. Let us rise and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered at Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, was buried, he descended to the dead, and the third he rose again, he ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Loving Father, help us to listen to the voice of your Son, the Good Shepherd, who protects us and leads us to greener pastures towards life's fulfillment. With confidence we pray, Father, keep us close to your heart.
Father, keep us close to your heart. Father, may Christ's legacy of love and his preaching of the gospel values be the inspiration of our church leaders and missionaries in their preaching and way of life. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Father, in the coming elections, enlighten us that we may choose candidates who, like Jesus, the Good Shepherd, truly care for the common good and give their heart and strength, that there may be peace, justice, and progress in our land. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Father, may all families become fertile seedbeds for vocations to priestly and consecrated life through the spirit of prayer, love, and service that reign among family members. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Father, may all of us who receive the grace of your Son's resurrection pursue integrity and build community where compassion and mercy abound for the sake of those who are sick, hungry, poor, and in dire need. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Father, give us strength to face the trials of this life, the pandemic, wars, those who are sick right now, and those suffering in any way. May we find healing and restoration in Jesus' love. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Father, may all of our beloved dead be consoled and find mercy in the one who laid down his life for all peoples. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Father, keep us close to your heart. We pray for clean, honest, accurate, meaningful, and peaceful elections. We pray for all Filipinos. Ask for the guidance of the Spirit to guide our votes. We pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
We also pray for all mothers that they may continue to be enduring examples of love and care for all of us. We pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us close to your heart.
Almighty God, you have given Christ, the Good Shepherd, the power over life and death. Through the most sweet name, to his most sweet name, graciously hear us and preserve in us the great joy of the Easter feast, now and forever.
Amen. peace always.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. To celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, Vicente, Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calonsod, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, Saint John of the Cross, all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now call upon God, our Father. Lord, we pray from every evil and graciously grant peace in our days. And by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace.
Oh,
friends, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
But in blood of Christ, may you serve everlasting life. Body of Christ.
Amen. For those who are joining our live stream celebration, let us now pray the spiritual communion prayer. O my Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you and I desire you to come into my heart. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, O never leave me. May the burning and most sweet power of your love consume me, that I may die for you who died for love of me. Amen. Please all rise.
Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Prayer for the 2022 national local elections. Let us pray that the forthcoming national local elections may truly reflect the will of the Lord who guides the destinies of nations. For every petition, we say, deliver us, Lord.
Deliver us, Lord.
From coercion, intimidation, violence, and terrorism.
Deliver us, Lord.
From honesty, dishonesty, lies, and all distortion of truth.
Deliver us, Lord.
From bribery, graft, and all conspiracy for fraud.
Deliver us, Lord.
From gullibility to the deceptive and blindness of perspective.
Deliver us, Lord.
From threats, intimidation, and perverse language.
Deliver us, Lord.
Let's also pray together our response, hear us, Lord.
Hear us, Lord.
That conscience may always be our ultimate norm.
Hear us, Lord.
That the common good may always be our highest goal.
Hear us, Lord.
That human dignity may be respected all the time.
Hear us, Lord.
That the poor and the weak may always have the priority.
Hear us, Lord.
That care for creation may never be ignored.
Hear us, Lord.
That solidarity may guide the path of peace and development.
Hear us, Lord.
That genuine fear of the Lord, of God, and love of neighbors may guide those who seek public office.
Hear us, Lord.
Let us pray. Together, Shepherd of souls and Savior of nations, politics is your gift to us, a call to serve others and grow in holiness. Guide our policies, our politics as you guide our lives. May our political engagement for voters and candidates bring glory to your loving name and help us grow in holiness forever and ever.
Amen.
These points will bless our mothers. If you can come forward, we'll have the blessing. Let us pray. God of all fruitfulness, God of all holy women, of Sarah, Ruth, and Rebecca, God of Elizabeth, Mother of John, of Holy Mary, Mother of Jesus, listen to our prayer and bless the mothers and grandmothers gathered here today. Bless them with the strength of your spirit. They taught us how to stand and to walk, how to speak, to play, and how to pray to you. Bless them with a place at your eternal dinner table. They fed us while we were still helpless, and later showed us how to feed ourselves. Bless them today with health and happiness, with joy and laughter, with pride in us, their children, and surround them with friends who are loyal and true. We also remember today the nameless women who down through the ages planted and harvested, cooked and baked, washed and cleaned, fed, clothed, and nursed the world. And finally, we ask you, God of all tenderness, to descend upon us all, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and your loved ones, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharist has been offered. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.